Hi there, I'm Square, and let's talk about anime. Cells at Work is an edutainment series that personifies the inner workings of the human body, from blood cells to platelets to cells that make up various systems like hair productions and liver functions. These various cells are shown as cute characters who you can easily grow attached to. In the show, we follow a brand new red blood cell as she navigates her way through the bloodstream, gets lost, makes friends, while learning with her along the way. Episodes cover such topics as the body's reaction to allergies, food poisoning, and the common cold. And while Cells at Work does touch on more serious subjects, the series usually ends on a smile. Pretty much a wholesome anime for the whole family, and one that you can really learn from as well. Cells at Work Code Black is a bit different. A lot of bit different. Cells at Work Code Black was originally presented to us as a grown-up version of Cells at Work, following the cells in a body ravaged by alcoholism, smoking, and constant amounts of stress. Code Black takes place in a body that seems to be slowly dying, and the show promises not to shy away from the darker and more real aspects of what the cells go through as the entire system fails around them. And this is what interested me. Cells at Work, at its heart, is an educational series. I wasn't sure how that would translate over to something a bit more adult-oriented. I did enjoy learning about new things while watching Cells at Work, but with a more serious tone in Code Black, would that same treatment come across as condescending or juvenile? So I decided to give it a try. I've been watching Code Black from the beginning, and now that we're at the last half of the series, there's one big question on my mind. Is it worth watching? Now, before we continue, I want to give a little disclaimer that this is a show that has some pretty dark and heavy and graphic visuals. If this makes you uncomfortable, if you don't feel like you have the stomach for that, it's probably best to leave now because I will be showing some of those visuals to make points within this review. And if that's the case, this show probably isn't for you. But if you feel like you can withstand dark, gory, scary visuals, stick around. So let's give a quick breakdown of the plot of the series. Cells at Work Code Black centers around a new red blood cell, a young man who's full of optimism, enthusiasm, and promise. We join the series with him just finishing up the training and starting his first day, rushing in headfirst and determined to do a good job. But things don't go smoothly. The idealistic version of the body that he saw during his training may have been accurate at one point, but not so much anymore. This red blood cell finds himself in a body that has been ravaged by time, stress, poor diet, and alcoholism. Paths that should be clear are full of grime. Systems that should work are slowly shutting down. There are fewer and fewer blood cells day by day. So our cell needs to work harder and harder with no breaks just to keep pace. Still determined to do a good job, he keeps going, but we can begin to see the cracks in his resolve as his efforts seem to not matter and the body continues to go downhill. Cells at Work Code Black is a series that isn't afraid to touch on dark, almost taboo themes. Now, while we do see episodes focused around subjects that aren't too serious like hair loss or all the blood cells working together so the body can achieve an erection, funniest episode in either series, by the way, there is an overarching sense of dread that clouds the entire series. The cells do achieve victory here and there, defeating invading diseases and even breaking through a blood clot, but the tiny bits of happiness feel fleeting. The body is dying, which means every cell inside will die. And from what it looks like, they'll all suffer while doing so. Cells at Work Code Black is an allegory for an abusive company. forcing its employees to work long hours, massive amounts of overtime in dangerous and abusive environments, and making it so nobody can just leave. Morale is non-existent. Everyone knows the work is pointless, but they all work. And they take their frustrations out on each other and themselves. Our protagonist seems to be a tiny light in a vast darkness, working hard with a smile on his face, encouraging others, finding unique solutions, and approaching every day and every problem with enthusiasm. But the series keeps beating him down. He gets back up, he keeps going, but his smile cracks a little bit more every time. This series does not pull its punches. There is massive amounts of death and body horror, starting as early as episode 1. And with the overall bleak outlook, the series comes across as dark and heavy, the complete opposite of its bubbly counterpart. But I feel the lessons still work. In most cases of ulcers, there's a specific bacteria found that is thought to aid in their development. The fungus that causes athlete's foot is commonly found on the skin and can turn into a real problem when you have a weakened immune system. These lessons are shown to us in a way where the viewer doesn't feel talked down to. It's all a part of the story, the adventure, the struggle. You may end up learning without realizing it. I don't know if I can say why this series works, but it does. And I find myself cheering for characters who don't have much hope. Characters who work hard but can't control what the owner of the body does. More alcohol, more tobacco, less sleep, but the characters keep going. I want them to succeed, even though I fear they won't. I worry who will die in one episode to the next. There's no plot armor here. Named characters fall constantly. This is a series not for the faint of heart. For its visuals, for its health anxiety-inducing story, for its existential dread that no matter what, the world may keep tumbling down around you. But I'm enjoying it. Not the world tumbling, but the series itself. So is the show worth watching? I can't say I would recommend it to everyone. But if you've made it through this review and you're still interested, give episode 1 a chance. It may surprise you. Heck, it might even make you rethink some of the health choices you're making in your own life. I know I have. So thank you so much for joining me today in this review. If you liked what you saw here today or heard from me, I would really appreciate if you would support the channel. Like, subscribe, comment, anything like that helps the algorithm. I also do stream on Twitch. I do art streams and game streams. You can see my schedule here. I stick to it most of the time, but I do stream random occasional ones outside of that as well. So if you follow my channel, you should get alerts for that. But ultimately, I just want to thank you for joining me today. I hope I see you all again, and please have an artsy day.